What's up, everybody? Day 334, making Songbringer. And today, I'm working on random numbers to overworld, getting the overworld to be better. I ran into a bug in the overworld, actually. It generated different worlds for different world seeds. Right? That was kind of crazy. What's up, Zilton? Nah, sorry, man. Today's going to be code day. No naming stuff. Unless you want to name this. So the bug I found was that on Windows, it's such a blunder, but basically on Windows, it was using a 32-bit seed, and on Mac and Linux, it's using a 64-bit seed. So long story short, different worlds were generated with the exact same world seed on Windows versus Mac and Linux. So the only way to fix that is either to move... the Windows seeds to be the exact same as the Mac or Linux, or the Mac or Linux to be the same seeds as Windows. No matter what, something's going to change. So, because of that, all the worlds are going to change in the next update for Songbringer. But that's actually going to be a really good thing. And in fact, if you already have your world, your game, saved with the old seeds and everything, your whole save game will be fine. You'll still have all your items. It's just that the overworld will change. And the dungeons will change the positions of everything. So, so I'm taking the opportunity to work on the overworld to make it even better, because everything's changing. Now this is a great opportunity to fix these few things that I've been wanting to fix for quite a while, like making the refills and the save points on the overworld very strategic, like they would happen right after a gate, for example. And secondly, making the dungeons more strategic as well, placing like dungeon 9 really deep in the world, really far away. And like you can see in this world right here, level 9 is all the way in the bottom right there, which is really red, very difficult area to get to. So I'm working on that, making it even better, and that's what I'm doing today. Name what? I'll name anything. Name this world. Name a world, man. Okay, so the interesting bit I'm at right now is working on the random number generator and the seeds. What's up, Red Sands? Howdy, howdy. The seeds, the random number generator, let me show you what I got so far. The random number generator, I've got it so when it generates random numbers, like for example here, starting off with seed Xanadu, which generates this number, and it starts off with no salt, zero salt. And then if that world fails for some reason to be created, this one failed because it couldn't connect all the maze segments, it moves on to use a different salt. So it goes salt plus one. But right now, the random number generator does salt plus, I have to do plus three, plus five, because it always generates the same random numbers if you use just a world seed that's only one different. It's just even versus odd. I don't know why. So I've been exploring all morning. I've upgraded the Tosworth random number generator, so it's still deterministic, still basically an integer based random number generator that I can ensure is the exact same on every platform that it runs on. Here's the upgraded four component Tosworth random number generator. Here's where I got it from. But the key is here in the DRAN state, I think. Maybe. I'm going to try an experiment here first. Name the world Brigadaria. Brigadaria it is, Zilton. This is Brigadaria. What's up, Bafu? Okay, so... I've got this idea. I tried initializing the random state with the 64-bit integer, shifting all the bits around and everything. Just didn't work. Actually, when I tried shifting around the bits, it started generating all the exact same random numbers. You can see here, here's a little snapshot of the random numbers that it generates each time, right? Thankfully, these are all different. But what I want to do is optimize the random number generator so that it generates different world based on only a one different seed. What's up, Zyinger? Hey. Okay, so first thing I want to do is go back to world and make it so it's it's only using a salt difference of one. Okay, so that, see, I'll show you what happens when I do this. You bought Songbringer? Cool, man. Thanks for buying it, man. Appreciate it. All everybody that pre-orders Songbringer, all that goes to support the development. So you can see it generated the exact same world, but it took twice as many retries because all the random numbers are coming out the same for the even numbers. Check this out. This seed is unique, but these two seeds are exactly the same numbers, even though it's a different seed. We've got seed ending in 22 there, seed ending in 23 here, but we got exactly the same random numbers. I don't know if this is a limitation of Tosworth or if this is a problem with the way I'm seeding the DRANDs. So that's my first step today, is I'm going to check and see if I can fix this seed. How does it generate a number? It would have to cycle through 1 to 1,000 to have the sequence stop randomly. Of course, for that, you would have to create a random number. No, this is already a proven random number generator. This is called the Tosworth algorithm. I'm not trying to reinvent the way random numbers are generated. What I want to do is create this random number generator deterministically. That's the whole goal, because you want the numbers to be exactly the same whether you're playing it on Windows, Mac, or Linux, or whatever platform. Always exactly the same random numbers. And to do that, you use integers, and that's all good. So what I'm saying is this bit here, this is the Tosworth random number generator. It's a four component generator. This is the algorithm Tosworth. But I think if I change the seed a little bit, we might be able to get better random numbers. So how do you, I forget how to rotate bit shift. Cause I think there's an assembly code to do rotating. I guess there is no. What about shriek numbers? What are shriek numbers? Hello, 190 proof. Maybe I have a random generator from 1 to 69. Then the number given from that is then added together, and this is kept being done until you have a six-number sequence. Shriek numbers represented by A. Have the random number generator come from the computer clock? No. Don't want to do that. This is meant to be a deterministic random number generator. It has to always generate exactly the same random numbers, no matter your platform, no matter the time of your computer clock. So here's a 32-bit shift. So I'm going to try shifting the seed just a little bit. So this is going to be a shift of 3. This one we don't want to shift this one. Yeah. So hopefully this makes it so, given a different seed, it can use a slightly different value for each one, each number in the random state. Okay, let's see if this works. If this works, then we'll get pure good random numbers. Check it out, 8 retries, hell yeah. I think it worked. Wow. Let's see. Okay, so first seed, random numbers, 344, 980, 10. Next seed, we're using, is only one number different. We got 160, 267, 30. Once again, we have one number different, 8, 132, 994. Yeah, this worked. Oh, nice. Yeah, it's just using a slight bit shift. Or not a bit shift, but a bit rotation. So what happens in a bit rotation is you're basically bit shifting, but any bits that you're shifting off the top or off the bottom get rotated around to the end of the bits, to the other side of the bits, basically. So you're preserving the data. You're just shifting the data. So that explains why this worked, and it worked really well. Oh, this is great. Basically, what this enables me to do is to pack in more data per bit. So basically, I can have world seeds that are only 32 bits and still get like really great results out of it, as if I had almost used a 64-bit random number generator. So this is awesome. Yeah. Oh, that's a big win. I can't, because I've been trying all morning for this, and finally, this idea worked. That's so cool. Mightiness, right? That's what those are called. Factorials. I never heard the name Shriek number before. What's up, Wutarius? Tobor Prime, what's up, man? Okay, so I'm checking this in. This is awesome. I get rid of this whole salt. Oh, this is so great. Yes. Random numbers, deterministic, and we're getting great values even if we change the salt by only one number. Oh, man, that's a big win. All right, cool. So let me just check this is all good, and we'll check this bit in, and then I got some more ideas. We'll work on the overworld. So we're using a rotate left there. We're setting the DRAND state. We're shifting it up and rotating it by one bit for each one of these random number states here. And we get much better values. Tobor, the work on the game's going great, man. How about yourself? I've been seeing some of your updates too. How's everything going, man? All right. The next thing I want to do is make it so it just generates better seeds. Because I'm using 32-bit seeds now, as opposed to 64, it makes the numbers shorter. And basically, here's how the math works out. With a 32-bit seed, good. Very ready to be done already. Nice. Do you have a set date that you? Do you have a release date yet, or are you like an approximate release date maybe? By the way, anybody watching this stream, Tobor's working on an awesome game, Savage the Shard of Gosen, right? It's still called Savage the Shard of Gosen, right? It's a great game. Sort of a side-scroller, but RPG. Okay, so anyways, we got 4294967296. That is 2 to the 32nd power. Basically, that's the maximum number we can get, right? We have 308 million world seeds. So you divide this number. This is the maximum amount of data we can possibly pack into 32 bits. Divide this by 308 million. That's approximately the number of world seeds we have in Songbringer. And you get 13.9. That means there's 13 numbers that can be used as salt for each one of the seeds. You got about 1,300 hours of work left? Whoa. Dang, man. I can't wait to see your game when it's all said and done. Because, man, you know what? No matter what your game is like the more time you put into your game, the better it gets. Like, I've seen this with many other people's games. Like, a game can transform and become something incredible with tons and tons of time. That's awesome, man. Summer, fall, cool. What's up, Jonah? Right? And it empowers me because I'm like, you know what? My art might have sucked a year ago, but today, dude, the art's getting way better. What's up, Boogie? Does it mean Songbringer will be delayed? No, he's talking about his game. We're not talking about Songbringer here. Oh, you're talking about, does that in general mean that Songbringer will be delayed? No, not. I'm going to try and get it out as soon as possible, but yeah. It'll just keep getting better after it gets released. Okay, so basically that gives us 13 numbers of salt per world seed. So my next goal is to make it so it's using an actual unique world seed for each, an actual number that's really, really well structured so that it actually generates different random numbers for every single world seed. That's the goal, right? Statistically, there may be a few world seeds that have exactly the same random numbers. I'm sure the chance of that should be very, very small, but it'll be really, really small, especially if I can get each one of these world seeds to have a unique number and then 13 numbers, a 13 number buffer basically where I could err and use some salt to fix it. You can speed run the content that is finished in about an hour and a half. Nice. What happened? I'm working on random numbers right now. I'm working on the world seeds. So I just made an improvement that makes it so I can use before I had to use even, or I always had to use odd numbered seeds. And I just made an improvement to the random number generator so that it can actually generate different random numbers for seeds that are only different by one number, which basically doubles the amount of worlds that I could pack into 32 bits. So my next goal is to make it so it's using a good world seed here. So I can guarantee that it's not overriding, like it's not, like, the same two worlds will never have exactly the same world seed. Oh yeah, no worries, man. Thanks. Thanks for saying that. Yeah, procedural is really interesting, man. I'm a programmer at heart. This is my biggest skill. I've always been a programmer. So this part of it to me is so intriguing. You know, sometimes I get in the phases where I'm like, dude, I just want to do art today, or I just want to do music or whatever, but some days I'm like, dude, I just want to do programming, and that's today. I'm just so stoked to get this all finished. And it all started because yesterday I found out that world seeds were different on Windows versus Mac. I'm like, shoot, really? I made a super duper blunder. I use 32-bit world seeds on Windows and 64-bit world seeds on Mac. So stupid. But anyways, it's caused me to kind of take a really detailed look at everything, and now I'm making it really rock solid on the bottom. The bottom bit of this entire video game is all based on these random numbers and all based on these world seeds and everything. So making this structure even stronger will be really awesome. And then I can go and fix the cool things, like I'm going to make, you know, I've already made it so level 9 is deeper, you know, and things like that. So refills are placed more ideally. The world seeds are just going to get better. Savage Law, you started out with procedural castle and cave creation, right? Yeah. Okay, so when it generates the world, here's the world seed generator right here. This takes the six letters that you use to generate your world and turns it into a long integer number. But right now, this is not the function. So get mega seed is long. So this function right here, I need to turn this into the right number. Okay, so if we've got 13 world seeds, hold on. We've got 26 letters in the alphabet. Raise that to the sixth power. These are the number of world seeds you can have in Songbringer, 308 million-ish. Multiply that by 13, and you've got this many. This is the amount of data we're going to be using up with all the world seeds. So let's copy that number. And then, so here's this number. Let's just remember that. What's up, Pedro? And 42949672296 minus that number. Here's the number we could start with. It would be okay. Let's start with that minus one. There. This is 2 to the 32nd power minus 26 to the 6th power minus one. All right, there. So we're starting with the good world seed, right? We're starting with a good number. Now, for every single seed, so we want to go red plus equals mega seed 0. Wait a minute. I think I'm guaranteed to have a six-letter world seed because it pushes back random letters until it doesn't. So I guess we'll just do this. If mega seed dot size is greater than 0, we'll do ret plus equals mega seed 0. The next letter, size is greater than 1, we're going to use mega seed 1, but this time we're going to multiply it by 26. Or actually, we need to do 13. Yeah, we need to do 13 here. Size greater than 2, we're going to use 26. Oh, this is 26 times 13 here. This is 26 times 26 times 13. What are we doing today? Well, I just explained it a couple times, but we're working on random numbers. Random numbers, the seeds for the worlds, improving it. So basically, the same 32-bit data can be used to generate all 308 million worlds really well. So packing in the random numbers so that the world seeds are really, really accurate. And basically, the whole goal of all this is to make it so all 308 million worlds will have different random numbers that are generated. And the statistical probability of that being false will be very, very low. Okay, so this I think will be generated much better random numbers, or much better world seeds. First of all, I'm going to run this and make sure nothing breaks, and then it still gives me a good world within a reasonable amount of retries. All right, we have a different world because, of course, the seed has changed. Let's check out how these seeds all turned out. We started off with world seed 942, blah, 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 881. 882, 883. Okay, good. And different random numbers? Yes, good. We've still got good quality random numbers being generated. Each time it's got different ones. Even if we're changing the world seed by only one number. Good. Okay. Now the whole point of this little tweak I'm making here is to make it so that this number, the integer number that you get generated out of the six-letter world seed, I want to make sure that is unique. So Xanadu should generate a world seed that's 13 numbers different than Xana T. In fact, let's track this number here. This is Xanadu. Let's go with world seed 2. Let's go one more letter, so V, Xanadu V. Oh wait, that's at the end. That's the end of the sequence. So this is going to be Xana Y. Xanadu. That should be 13 numbers different. What does Xana do? Nice one. Nice one. Xanadu. Okay, so that number should be only 13 different. Xanadu, we got that. Did this turn out right? Yeah, nice. 881, 894. Great. Okay, let's verify one more thing. I've got this little check here in the overworld scene, which can run through a bunch of different world seeds. So I'm going to set up a little run and create a bunch of worlds. 52, we'll create 52 worlds. And I just want to make sure that let's reverse all these numbers too. It's going to log these worlds, comment out this return. So it's going to run through 52 different worlds here, generate the entire world. It'll show how many retries it took, and it will also show me the world seeds that it used. It's taking a minute here. See, it's generating a bunch of worlds. Yeah, so there's 13 possibilities for the number for each seed. So it when a world fails to be created, it will increase the salt by one. So it starts off with the first world seed that you give it. And then it will go to the next world seed. It will, if it fails in that world, it'll try one different, and then one different, and then one different. Until it gets a world that works. that was kind of a lot of data for it to pump out, and I'm not sure if how helpful it's going to be actually. So, but we did get mega seed turned out to be that, and it took a few retries. So this is not cool. I don't want to see this data. I want to see some simpler data. I just want to see the world seeds. Let's see world get seed as long. What if the 13 worlds fail? It'll keep on going. It goes up to 255. The problem with if it does fail more than 13 times in a single world, what will actually happen is it will use random numbers from the next world. So statistically, I'm trying to make that as low as possible. Like most worlds should succeed in under 13 tries. Most of them do at this point. Most of them succeed in like maybe 8 tries maximum, but more like 0, 1 to 5 tries is kind of the average, right? So there will be some outliers. Some worlds will not succeed in those 13 tries, and that means that their random numbers will simply just start using their random numbers from the next seed. So it's not like the world's going to end or anything, and it's not like it's going to fail to create it. It's just that some worlds, a small amount of worlds, will be exactly the same. If I can't get the world seed generator to be even better. I think I can get I can improve the world seed generator and everything and take care of some of these cases. For example, what are some cases that just cause these worlds to fail? No possible doors for room -2, -1. Unable to place 4 from light areas. Unbalanced level entrances, 6 on the left, 3 on the right. These kinds of things cause worlds to fail because it just doesn't create a pretty enough world, or it's not that ideal to play. So I can improve the world generator, and then it will use less salt per world. It's not the end of the world, really. Okay, I'm going to create another function called setSeed. So it's theoretically possible that two different but consecutive world seeds will generate the same world. Exactly. Yeah. Yep. It's theoretically possible, but it's a small chance at this point. And it will get even better as I improve the world generator. Okay, so I'm basically creating a method called setSeed. So that, in fact, there's a function called seed. I should probably just make this better here. Yeah. So I'm going to call, world set seed. Game get save game key mega seed. All right, and then inside the set seed method, we'll fix this all up. This is ensure mega seed is enough characters. Basically, if you enter a world seed that let's say you enter a world seed, it's only three letters long. This will generate some more letters based on some other deterministic random numbers based on whatever world seed you already have. So it will always deterministically generate a long enough world seed, even if you only give it like one letter. How much time does it take to test generate a world? Maybe you could brute force your way through 309 million worlds and see the culprits. It takes, okay, I've been measuring this morning. Check it out. Each one of these worlds gets created in usually around 25 milliseconds to 50 milliseconds is, I think, the average. The outliers are around 100 to 150 milliseconds. So that's to create the entire world. And these outliers are basically because the world is like crunching through different things. It's got random numbers that it basically has to create all these paths and stuff like that. So some worlds can just take longer. But I could probably improve that as well. But it does take quite a while to generate all the worlds and output all the data. So if I turn off all the output, then it would help generate the worlds a lot faster. So I could do that. And that's what I have this algorithm in that other function for, is generating a bunch of different seeds and trying out a lot of different worlds. Okay, in this bit here, it would take less than a year to test them all. Wow, dude, that's a long ass time. Dude, wow. I have to go in 15 minutes, but I wanted to see you. It's been a long move month. It's been a long month? All right, man. Okay. I made some changes here. I made it so I can set a seed. And get the seed differently. First of all, let's make sure I'm gonna turn off this log worlds function. We should still have the same worlds. It shouldn't like overdo anything here. Like it shouldn't like get in any infinite loops or any kind of weirdness because of what I just changed here. 8 retries. That seems good. I think that's what it was before. So it started with Yanadu. Yanadu, Yanadu, Yanadu. These are all the tries. It's failing. And it succeeds on the 8th try. We got 149, 32 milliseconds, 32 milliseconds, 30 milliseconds, 50 milliseconds, 48. Yeah, these are all reasonable. Great. Same worlds. Good thing. Okay, so we'll turn this off. And now we're going to test 52 different worlds. All it's going to do is just... I'm going to log out all the world seeds. So this world seed is seed.seedster, and this world seed has that seed as the integer. Okay, so that'll show me 52 different world seeds. Just to make sure that these numbers are coming out how I thought they were. 13 different on each one. That one took 2 retries for Okay, something's wrong. It's creating the same number each time. Oh, I think I forgot to call set seed. Duh. All right, so world set seed, and then show what it set. There we go, good. So is different from ba by only 13 numbers. 13 numbers. Every time it goes up by 13 numbers. And let's see that reversed. What if I were increasing the top number? Let's go one number different. Let's switch B and A. And we can do a lot more of these worlds. Max 1,000. These are fast. Wait a minute, it didn't change. Well, we can look at ABBA versus A. Wait, why didn't B and A swapping? Oh, F. It's not F. It's not A and B. I wanted to swap E and F. Switching DNA. Yeah, I should have switched DNA. Okay, so here we go. Yeah, we're switching just the second letter now. And we should be different by 26 times 13 each time. So yeah, we get about 1,000 numbers different on each one of these. Next, let's swap. Let's make this A and this F. So this should change the number a lot. But still, we should have still under 42949672296. As the top number. Yeah, check this out. Oh, it overflowed. Damn, we got an overflow. Maybe I did the math wrong here. Oh, I totally did. Oh. I don't think I'm supposed to multiply the 13 in each time. It's a good thing I checked this. Back in world, I think that this second multiply by 13. No, this is definitely not necessary because this is only for the first digit that we need to multiply by 13. And then we're adding in the second digit. We're multiplying it by 26. An overflowing dam. And how do I check that? Huh. First of all, let's take off these 13s. This might need to be like 39 or something. See, that kind of feels wrong. That one's times 13, that one's times 26. I don't know, I guess I'm trying to code by intuition only. No, not entirely. I guess I'm checking all these numbers. I just want to make sure this is working here. Yes, I do have a debugger with the breakpoint. Why would I use one here? Alright, okay, these are the end world seeds. I want to go back one where we were swapping only a second letter. But it does, let's see, did we overflow that time? I don't think so. No, we didn't overflow. Yeah, these are all similar numbers. But I don't think they're enough. It should have been and then za. A, B, C, D, E, F. Let's do that in order that way. So we should be increasing the number quite a bit each time. That's a lot of retries. But we're changing the numbers each time. It's not the retries that's really changing. Abs. Why am I getting? Oh, I wanted za. Okay, I wanted this. The original. So I'm just ensuring that I'm actually packing in these 13 numbers per world seed the right way. 60 retries again. Oh yeah. I haven't changed anything here. See, by the time we get to za, we should be really high in the numbers. Oh no, this is, no, this needs to be like this. Cache it, did you feed the seed just into a pseudo random number generator? Do you do, no, this is a Tosworth deterministic random number generator. Here's the algorithm I'm using, it's Tosworth. This is all integer based. It's deterministic. I can get the exact same world out of any platform because I'm using integers, which are naturally cross-platform. Floating point numbers, not friendly for cross-platform. Free parking. All right, here. Okay, now we should be getting, by the time we get up to we should be 4 billion numbers deep, but we're not. Yeah, oh, now that I think about it, that 13 was supposed to be in there. Shoot, okay. Let's undo all these changes. All these do need to be multiplied by 13. That feels right. Yeah. Did I make a mistake here then? Or maybe I made a mistake in the bottom of the seed. Don't know. Let's see. So we start with a. We've got a 2 billion number. All right. Wait. Yeah, see, it overflowed. When it overflowed right when all the way got to just p even. I know the first one's right. Yeah, and the second one's got to be right too because you've got 26 different letters. Oh, I see what's wrong. I totally see what's wrong. I'm using the ASCII code right here instead of the letter number. Shriek numbers are essentially the starting number times by the numbers preceding it. Right. Like a poly is it a polynomial or a factorial? I think the word I knew for that was factorial. So this needs to be mega seed zero. Let's make a little get car function. We'll call this letter to int car c. Or no, we'll give it const string ref string and the int index. In the string. So if the string dot size is greater than the index, then return the character at that index minus capital A. And then mod that by 26. So we've guaranteed that a letter is from 0 to 25. Always. Let me just make sure that works. Like all the numbers preceding it from n to 1. Huh. Shriek numbers, huh? Cool. Okay, so if this, make sure this worked. If the string size is greater than your index, so for example, if you passed index 5, size 6 is greater than 5, so we would do s at 5 minus a, mod that by 26, return it yes. Okay. So this is now, let's get rid of all of these. And this is going to become, let's inline this and static it. And we go letter to int, mega seed, zero. Hello, Jonathan. What's up? Welcome to the stream, man. Yeah. 1,000 points. That's the minimum raffle. All right, almost ready to have this fixed random number generator going. There we go. So now we got a proper function, letter to int. Now we shouldn't be overflowing, and we should still be getting great numbers. Thanks, Jonathan. Appreciate you saying that, man. Nice. Test your shriek-based random number gen. You might come up with the next awesome world or random number generator. Yes, nice. Right, we still have 26 retries. That's okay. It's decent. Let's see how these random numbers came out. So world seed, yeah, we're starting with the lower number. And then getting up all the way up to Az, this should be close to 42949467296, which it is, but it's still under. Yes. All right. Let's go backwards. Let's start with Z and go down to A. Oh, wait, I would want to go with Z with all these. Really? So I'm going to start with really high random seeds and work my way back down to lower random seeds. Just looking at the numbers here, making sure that ZZZZZZZ generates a number that is really close to 2 to the 32nd power. In fact, it should be one number less because I did minus one there. Right? Numbers are cool. Numbers are interesting. Especially when you can make a whole world out of just a 32-bit number. A whole 308 million worlds, 32 bits. It's different random numbers for each one. Wait, we didn't print anything this time. What happened? Oh, dude, did I just mess up these loops? I messed up the loops. What'd I do wrong? A. Oh, this is gonna be greater than. All right, good day to you too. 26 retries. That's funny. We have 26 letters, 26 retries. All right, cool. Yeah, z z z z z z. We get 42949672822. Oh, right, an 82 would be plus 13. That gives it 13 numbers for it to give its random state. Let's see what happens to that world if it blows past its random state. So wait, hold on. Add 13 to that, and we have 4, 9, 5 on the dot. Right on. Actually, we should probably subtract 255 from that just in case. So if this random world failed z z z z z z z, it's not going to overflow and get its random number seed all the way back to zero. So let's subtract. This is the last little. This is the icing on top of the cake here. For this, is going to be in world. This start seed right here is going to be minus 256. Let's do that math again. 4, 2, 9, 4, 9, 6, 7, 2, 9, 6. Minus 2 to the, I forgot what that is. 26 to the 6th power is, that's how many worlds we have. And then 4, 2, 9, 4, 9, 6, 7, 2, 9, 6 minus this. Wait, what? No. I did it wrong. This is times 13 right here. I messed up. Raised to the 6th power. Multiply that by 13. There we go. That's our number. And then we've got 4, 2, 9, 4. That's our minimum seed, minus 256. 27906. 27906. Good. There we go. So that leaves a lot of random numbers at the end that it could mess up with. Yeah! Oh, this is sweet. If from the start of the Big Bang there are around 1 billion creatures on an almost infinite landscape of planets, all shuffling cards and 108 times a second, only now would they start repeating stacks. Dang. No, not 4 billion worlds. There's 308 million worlds. Those 4 billion random numbers for the entire game. Random number seeds. All right, this is the awesomest thing ever. I got the world seeds dialed in and the random number generator, so it's even better. So I can now comment out this stuff in scene. I'm using to debug. We can just return there. Make sure it doesn't do that anymore. This is kind of like a test function right here. I can go and check this code in. Oh, I don't want this to accidentally like run 1,000 worlds next time. It's looping from Z down to A. That's fine. I can change that back later. I got a better world seed function. Get mega seed. World set seed. Get save game key file mega seed. Show it. Seed the DRANs. This is the better set seed function. It takes a given seed. Make sure that if it's less than the size, it generates more to fill up. So it's at least 6 letters. And then it also resizes in case it's more than 6 letters. And then we've got this awesome letter to int function, which makes sure that every integer ASCII gets converted nicely into a value between 0 and 25. Even if that's a number outside the range of A to Z. And then we've got this new random number generator, or seed. This is a new seed generator based on the letters that gives us a guaranteed seed between 0 and 4 billion with 13 different values of salt that can be used. Awesome. Man, this is so cool. It's so great to get this geeky and then have it all see how all work out and verify that it all worked out too. So, seed generator guaranteed to fit into 32 bits for all 308 million worlds given 13 different salt values per possible per world. All right, now it's time to start doing the interesting stuff. I have a weird question. Do you work standing? Yes, I work standing. I'm the same height when I get off the chair. I float. That's right. Yeah, Jonah. I float. Okay, so when I run this... Let's see what kind of worlds, now that everything has changed, every single world has changed in this game. So that means if you're playing a game right now and you want your world to be exactly the same with Songbringer, you're playing the beta version right now, you might want to back up your entire Songbringer directory if you really want to play that world out, because the next update, which is going to come out in about a week, every single world will change. You'll still be able to have all your items. Everything you've already found will still be there. It's just that the world will have changed and the dungeons will change too. So next up, I want to make it so there's a lot of different worlds that fail. So what's this world? Xanadu? Let's go back to Xanadu. Number File. That's a really cool channel. I like the Number File episode about you randomly running into your exact same configuration of atoms if the universe were any bigger. So here we go. I want to optimize it. See how this world right here got generated after 17 retries. That means it threw away 16 different worlds because the world didn't work out for some reason. That is going to need to be statistically less than 13 for all these worlds to truly be unique. So I want to go and find the points where it's using up a lot of different retries by finding the most common the common things that cause worlds to fail. Try the World Seed Canada. All right, next beta update it will change your world. That's right. All right. All right, Zilton, we're going Canada. Yeah, I know you love naming stuff, so we're going to name this World Seed Canada from the rest of today's debugging and all this world generation awesomeness. It will all be based on that. So hopefully we have a lot of retries here. We don't have a lot of retries, but that's okay. At least we have six of them. So I'm going to go and look at those six retries and figure out what's some of the common denominators, the problems that should be, you know, common things so we can solve the common ones basically and get better worlds. I think this one I know I can fix, and I know I've seen it a lot. It's called unbalanced level entrances, and let me illustrate exactly what that is. Here's the random seed we started with. I'm going to force that random seed, so you're always gonna let's I'm gonna all these worlds don't matter anymore, actually. Except for that one. That one was really interesting. I want to keep this world around. Okay, here's the world seed we have. Because I'm using a forced random seed, it's not going to go and try do any retries, but it will show us. Yeah, so it couldn't create the world because that world fails. It's got unbalanced level entrances. Okay, so now when we go to unbalanced level entrances, I'm going to make it, instead of failing the entire world, it's going to succeed immediately that world. So I can take a look on the map and see what happened. So it's going to generate this world. It's going to realize, oh my God, this world has unbalanced level entrances. There's so many on the left versus so many on the right. Let's take a look at what that did. Okay, so here's the world. It's generated all these maze paths and everything. It's placed the gates, all those little G's or gates, and then it's placed all the dungeons too. The numbers are the dungeons. So as you can see, it's got three dungeons on the left side of the map, 2, 5, and 6. And then it's got six dungeons on the right side of the map, 4, 7, 8, 9, and 3, and 1, and 1. Okay, so yeah, 6 on the right, 3 on the left. I've got an idea how to fix this, so that it will use up. In fact, we need to check and see, is this generating verbose maze? No, we want to see a more verbose maze. So I'm going to turn on maze verbosity 2. Oh, 3 at the corner? Yeah, I missed that one. Yeah, okay, so here, yeah, we're still at 0 retries. Yeah, 3 at the corner, you're right. 4, 1, 7, 8, 9, 3. Man, so it's a very unbalanced world, right? So as it's generating the world, it lists out all the possible places it could put dungeon entrances. See, here's how it starts out. It goes, I don't need this anymore. This is from my Windows checking. I can get rid of that. Oh, and this is all to change now too. I don't need that. Okay, this is good. Clear up this other information that's in the way, right? Okay, so here's what we have. When first let's create this world. It goes and it places all these cliff faces, and then it's got this many dead ends that it could possibly use up. 14 dead ends. It places the first 5 dungeons close to home. So dungeon 1, dungeon 2, dungeon 3, dungeon 4, dungeon 5, all of those are as close to home as possible. And then it does the reverse strategy for the remaining dungeons. It puts them as far away as possible. So 9 is just like as far away as you could possibly get. So it places those first 5, and then it's got all these different remaining spots it could put levels, right? I want to see something here. I want to see. I guess if you want to find the most common causes for rejected world, you would have to try a number of different seeds. No, I've already tried this a bunch, like last night, and I know that this particular case right here, where it's got unbalanced level entrances, is quite a common one. So by fixing these unbalanced level entrances, I'll fix a lot of different worlds. Or a lot of different worlds that might have been broken for a pretty easy. And I got an idea. This could be fixed pretty easily. Yes, I will definitely be checking a lot of seeds. But right now, I know I can focus on this one particular issue and fix that. And then later, once I've fixed a few of these issues, right, I can go back and run a test on a bunch of different world seeds and make sure that this is all good. I want to see the count left and the count right every single time. If, as long as they're greater than 0. And the first time we log dead ends, we'll go 0, 0. It's not gonna add that info. And the next time we log dead ends, and then the next time we can pass in count left and the count right. So we can see how many are left, how many are right after each step, each phase. Doing the dirty work off screen? Right? This is the dirty work off screen. You mean like the dirty hard part of all this or what? Okay. So I'm just looking at data here, looking at output. Okay, we got 14 remaining dead ends to start with. It places 5 dungeon entrances, and it's got, at that point, it has 2 left, 3 right. And then by the end, oh wait, so we already placed 2. We have 2 left, 3 right. Hold on. Right. Yeah, this is the dirty work off screen. I get you. This is hard work, right? This is hard, difficult stuff, but it's going to make this game even better, you know? I'm guaranteeing that every world is unique. Is if possible. There may be some, of course. It's nice seats. All right, we got a lot of cool seats here, Zilton. Fan art, dick butt. Abaddon. Oyster. Nice. Oyster, that's a cool one. So my question is this: were there some enough world seeds that we could have balanced this world out? In fact, if I had just put one more on the left right here, we would have been okay. And shit, yeah, we got one world on the left right here. We got two worlds on the left, so we could have fixed this world. So that's my next goal. I want this algorithm to work so that when it's placing the last dead ends, the last four dead end or the last four dungeon entrances should be smart. Like if there's an unbalanced left right, we should favor left or right. All right. So the second half of levels go far from home and prefer balance. So we need to do a double loop here. We need to loop on the outside. One of them is bound to be broken beyond repair, for sure. There's always going to be something wrong, even though, you know, that's what's so great about it. It's a little bit out of my control, right? I can't quite fix everything. I can't quite make the perfect game. So that's what's beautiful, right? There's going to be some world out there where it's just totally fucked up and everybody tries to play it or whatever. Maybe that's some awesome glitch world. Right, and the seeds have me. Oh, you mean all those? The world seeds you're talking about? Yeah. All right, so we're going level is greater than level split. Level. Level minus minus. And dead ends dot size is greater than zero. There's our outside loop, our inside loop. So for every single one of these levels, we want to loop over all the dead ends and make sure. This is going to be break. This we don't need to worry about. So yeah, if we're looping over every remaining dead end, and if it's, and we want to check the balance too, so. Are you talking about the world buggy? Buggy's the world we played this last Saturday during the playthrough of the latest beta update, and it did have some cool bugs, actually, that were really important bugs to fix. So thanks again, Jonah, for suggesting that. And man, I'm really actually pretty excited about how many bugs got fixed this weekend. I released the update on Saturday night, and then Sunday I spent the whole day fixing bugs. And so there was two updates this weekend to Songbringer. So anyways, if we have count left is greater than count right, we want to prefer the right. So, and p dot x is greater than half the, here we go, constant level split. Let's go constant size split, or size x. Let's call it x split. This is going to be size x shifted down one. There's our x split. So if p dot x is greater than or equal to x split, we're going to add another or. Okay, so or if count left is less than or equal to count right, and p dot x is less than x split, and we place a level. So I'm gonna review my code now. I think what this will do is prefer balancing out the world for the last dead ends, but let's make sure that works. Actually, if count left equals count right, this is an even more optimal here. If count left equals right, we don't care. If count left is greater than right, we prefer to the right. And if count left is less than right, then we got to the left. Where did I mess that up? Oh, this needs an extra. Wow, that's a long ass. Super long. Okay, so yeah, let me just make sure this is right. All right, we got the second half of levels. This is levels 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If level is greater than level split, and dead ends outside is greater than 0, level minus minus. So there's a possibility that it didn't. There's a possibility that it might not create all the levels, but that's okay. It checks to make sure by checking the count left and the count right. So if count left equals count right, we can proceed to place the level. Or if count left is greater than count right, so that means that we've got more on the left than we got on the right, and this position is to the right. Yes, that will bring balance. And if this is count left is less than right, which means there's more levels on the right or right heavy, then we're going to prefer to the left. So p dot x is less than x split. And then making sure these loops are all good inside their brackets, and then place a level. I think this will work. So after it does place a level, it erases it from the dead ends and breaks from the dead ends loop. It breaks out of this loop and goes and does the next level. So there's a chance that it loops through and can't place a level. But then it'll fail here. Five unplaced level entrances. So that did not work at all. All right, here's where I need to step through. I'm gonna set a breakpoint here. As soon as we start picking these levels, I need to figure out why this isn't working. And these need to be on different lines. Oh, I got an idea. This could be way simpler if it was just Let's see if that worked. Just restructuring that. I don't think this will work, but we'll try it. No. Okay, good. Same results. All right, so now it's time to step. All right, we're starting with level 8, which is actually dungeon 9. This is from 0 to 8. We got count left is 2, count right is 3. So we're looping over all our dead ends. How many dead ends we have? We have 9 remaining dead ends. Let's take a look at the first one, the last one. The first one's 12-1-0, and we got 15-5-0. Stepping into this loop, we've got auto P should be the first one. 15-5. Oh, that's the last one. Oh, right, because we're reversing this loop. Starting with the end. So we're going beyond that iterator. Okay, so if count left is equal to count right, no, it's not. Count left greater than right, nope. Count left less than right, yeah. P dot x less than x split, should be. So we got P dot x, 15-5. So 15, is that less than our x split, which would be 8? No. So it can't place a level there. That's fine. Okay, so our next position in this list is 15-7. Going in reverse, that's 15-7. Okay, we're advancing past it. Still, we have count left, count right, so we're going to be favoring. We're favoring all these things on the right, which means. Wait, no, we're favoring on the left. So we're looking for. Basically, we're going to step through this list until we get to this one, 07. Because 15 will fail, 15 will fail, 13 will fail. So now we're at position. We should be at, what, 13? Yep, this one should fail. Next one. This one should succeed. We've got position 07. Once again, our count left, count right. P dot x is less. Yes, we succeed. All right, now it should be successfully placing this level. Oh, which may not happen in some cases, of course. All right, place level, and we don't want to place levels if you already have an entrance nearby. Okay, it didn't. So there, it's placing dungeon entrance 9 at 07, which is all the way up in the top left of the world. We go set the flag. If p dot x is less than size x, shifted down 1, we got count left increased. Return true. Which means we're going to erase this iterator. So we're going to be erasing. Here's the critical part. We're erasing 070. So this one, number 5, should go away. And we should have 12-7, 13-7. Yeah, 12-7, 13-7. We should only have 8 elements now. Yeah, it worked. Okay, so now that should break out of that loop. We should go to the next level. Level is 7 now. L- Level 7. All right, so we're looping through over the dead ends again. This time we're starting, once again, we'll start with 15-5. And this time it shouldn't care if count left equals count right, which it does. Oh my God, I see what's going wrong. If it ever increments past it, and if level is ever decremented without placing a level, then the whole thing will fail. I wonder which one it's failing on. It's probably not this one because count left equals count right. If place level, good. Break there. We got position now is 15-7. We still haven't placed that one. Count left, count right. We've got 3-4 on the right now. So we're going to skip that one. P's 12-7. That one's it's going to skip. P17, this one it should succeed. Yes, we get into the loop, but do we get through place level? Let's see. Now, see, it doesn't have that nearby flag. I bet you this is what's failing it. So it goes, nope. Continues the loop. All right, we've got 7 remaining dead ends, 15, 13, 12. We're back at it. We're still at this count left, count right. 9-7 is going to fail. Do we have anything that will succeed here? We already tried 1-7, so there's 9-7. There's only 2-5, which could also fail. This is probably what's happening, huh? So next we got 9-7. Wait, did we already try 9-7? No, this one's 2-5. Yeah, so if 2-5 also fails because of a nearby flag, then this whole loop will fail just because it didn't work. Yep, that one fails too. And then because that fails, it's going to decrement level anyways. Which makes sense. This world should fail because no other dungeon entrance is going to be able to be placed. Oh. So this is a genuine world fail here. There's no way for it to rectify the situation given its remaining amount of dead ends. One thing we could do is to change the split a little bit. The level split. It's currently world num levels shifted down 1. If we subtract 1 right there, we're going to be providing more opportunity for the end dungeons to succeed, to rebalance the force, if you will. Let's see what happens. All right, it still failed. But why does it say 6 unplaced level entrances? Oh. Wait a minute. 11, 1, 3, 5, 15, 0. It's skipping over. Every time it's skipping over. This is not reporting the unplaced level entrances right, though. Okay, world num levels. Oh, this is supposed to be minus. Count left plus count right. Okay, what happened this time? Two unplaced level entrances. But it's not using all the beginning ones. Which it should be. I'm not exactly sure why, so once again, I'm gonna set a breakpoint there. I wanted to definitely use up those levels just right. Left. Or the first one, the next one. Okay, so we're starting off. We have dead ends of size 14. They're actually made of cotton. So soft. Oh, yeah. Nice on the buttocks. In your Game of Thrones. Nice usage. All right, so we should be using up 11-1-0. First of all, let you just do that. If place level. All right, so we're placing in direction of it. It's hard to see what it is. 11-1. Yep. Go ahead and place level 1. Now we should have 12-1. 12-1 is right next to 11-1. No wonder. Oh, it was working. It was just skipping because those are so close to each other. Look at that. 12-1 is right next to 11-1. 3-5 is right next to 2-5. But 15-0 is different than 9-4. Oh, I get it now. So we had 11-1, 12-1, 3-5, 2-5, 15-0, 9-4. So it should have done 11-1, skip 12-1. We've got 3-5, skip 2-5. We've got 15-0, and then 9-4, and then 2-7. Oh, it makes complete sense. Okay, I guess one more thing we could do is to make it so it can also succeed to place, to go ahead and try, you know, out a level. It could go, if it's getting desperate, if it's down to the line, like if, like if we only have two more level entrances to place and we have Actually, we could just go the last one. Wait a second. No, I don't think that would work. I don't think it would help. Well, I guess it would work, but it wouldn't help. Oh, okay. I got it. So we'll go bool, failed, false. Actually, we need to put that out here. Bool failed equals false. Yeah, so if we get to the end of this loop, if we go it is it equal to dead ends dot end, then we go failed equals true. So we can track that. And the next time we do this loop, oh, this is our end. If we've failed, we'll call this one failed once. Failed once, go ahead. Right, let's see if that worked then. So we've got a variable failed once, starts at false. If we go through this entire loop, we try out every single dead end, and we don't get to break, we don't succeed at placing the level. Then we go it equals dead ends dot r end. Failed once is true. So it's going to loop out of here. It's going to go to the next level and start trying to place it. No. I guess we could go failed once here equals false. So kind of keep a running track. And I think what it needs to do is not decrement level minus minus until here. See, the problem with always decrementing level minus minus is if you don't end up actually placing a level, then the next time it's not going to try and place level 5, it's going to try and place level 4 or whatever, so it's always going to skip them. It's going to skip a level if it can't be placed. But we still need to break out of this overall loop somehow. If we've tried every level and failed, yeah, if we fail, and we've already failed, then we're going to break out of this loop. Wow. That was kind of a long think there, but I hope this is going to work now. Hey. Nice. All right, what did it do that time? It went 1, 5, 6, 7, 3, 2, 8, 9. Now it still had an unbalanced world, but at least it succeeded that time. Let's see what happened. So it had 14 dead ends to start with. It placed a few of them, four of them. It's got 10 remaining dead ends, one left, three right. Starts off unbalanced. So it places dungeon entrance 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. I want to see if it's failed already. Here is always false. Here, we pass in failed once. And here, I want to set a breakpoint. I want to make sure it's getting to that on that last one. Okay, once again, it successfully places the first four, no problem. Ah, good. Now we can see that it failed once here. Done in dungeon entrance to 7. It did successfully. So this whole time, these last two times, it had, three left, six right? Hold on. I'm not sure if this is working. You found a bug where you can take points? Is that what it is? Oh. Yeah, I need some better debug data here. So whenever it places a dungeon entrance, I want to see left and right. Here we go. All right. So it started off 0 left, 1 right, 1 left, 1 right, 1 left, 2 right, 1 left, 3 right. Kind of got an unbalanced world here. But it starts to try and balance it out in the remaining dungeons. 2 left, 3 right. All right, good. It balanced it out. It had 3. Now it balanced to 3 left, 3 right. And then it didn't care. So it placed 15, 5. And then we got 3 left, 5 right because it failed once. And then 3 left, 6 right because it failed again. So the critical moment was right here where it chose to go ahead and place level 15, 5. Huh. I'm not sure if this world can be corrected. These are all the dead ends it has. I guess if it were really to correct itself better, it would have to take a look at every single dungeon entrance and then throw away the ones that were too close to each other. But do that in a smart way. So it would have to, like, for example, if like 11-1 and 12-1, this is actually a great example right here. 11-1, 12-1, those could never, ever... Those could never ever be they're right next to each other, so it's not gonna allow those to be placed. So we might as well throw those out at the beginning, and to be smart about it, it would throw away the 12 one, because the 11 one might be a little closer to other levels. I mean, I guess that totally depends though, because we got 15-0 right here. Man, I'm not sure if this is gonna be a big enough win though. Yeah, I don't know if this is a big enough win really, because yeah. If I were to go to all the trouble of throwing away worlds beforehand, it still might not even help to balance the world out. See, 2-7 and 1-7 are also right next to each other. And then we got 12-7 and 13-7 right next to each other. There's so many dead ends in this world that are right next to each other. And I guess that would make sense from a maze generator perspective. It probably does statistically create dead ends that are close to each other, because once you've got one dead end, you've got a surrounding area that's kind of ripe for more dead ends. So that makes sense why that would be. Oh my gosh, I guess I could make the maze generator a little smarter, and then it wouldn't stop for a dead end automatically. Hold on a second. I think I could check in what I got so far. This is attempt to balance levels. And if I turn off the world seed, the force world seed, we'll see how many retries it takes to get the world now with this balance, this attempted balance. We got 3 retries. That's better. Before we had how many retries? I think it was 8 retries before. We got it down to 3. No, was it? I don't know. Maybe it was only 4 retries. We got it down to 3. Whatever. It's an improvement. A slight improvement. I'm going to check this in so far. And then try one more thought along these lines. Oh, I might have, that might not have actually generated a better world or less retries, because I had that as return true. Six retries. I don't think we've made any improvement yet so far today on that part. There's been a lot of other improvements, but let's at least get this checked in. So this is, attempt to balance dungeon entrances. All right, back to verbosity 2, and there's this bit here in the maze generator where it automatically creates a dead end if you've hit a certain run length. So my thought is this. I'm gonna kind of pseudocode this one. And just basically ensure that this position doesn't have a dead end adjacent for that, we would probably use this thing's count openings. So the maze generator count openings. But I'm not sure. The maze hasn't already generated itself all the way. Oh, I can use count empty. Nice. So we go and not this count empty to the left. Actually, we need a little has dead end function. Has dead end equals this, given an x2 and a y2. No, given an x and a y. This is return. This count empty x, y equals 0, and this count openings x, y equals 1. That's a dead end. So basically, it has to have traversed and created it needs to have filled in that area completely. This is where it's testing its count empty. Maybe we should make sure that's right. For each quadrant, x2, y2, if it's not traversed and there's no openings, then it's a completely empty area. So if this is a not empty area and it only has one opening, that's a dead end. So if we don't have a dead end, at x2 shifted down 1, y2 shifted down 1, oh, and we also need to go this is valid. So if it's a valid position and it's not empty and it has one opening. So in here we're checking if it not has dead end to the left, and not has that end to the right. It doesn't have a dead end below. And it doesn't have a dead end above. So this should hopefully make the maze generator smarter. See, this is basically, it's automatically creating a dead end every like 17 tiles or so. Every 17 areas, it makes sure to place a bunch of dead ends. But the whole goal is to place the dead ends far away from each other, if possible, so that we're not getting this problem with the dungeons not being able to be created. So hopefully this doesn't break the whole maze generator here. Okay, that time we had less retries. This might have worked. World Seed Canada. Wow, it worked. I hope it didn't break anything else, though. So it took a few retries, though. Oh, it was able to place all these dungeons just fine. Even balanced them out. It was unable to place some gates. And then finally it succeeded on the third try. Okay, well, let's see if this really is working. The world, 2026. The Earth has been devastated from the continuous use of nuclear weapons and biological warfare. Man's last remaining hope are points, a drug that replaces the need for conventional food and drink. Nice! Points has its downside. For starters, it's usually traded in for ad quote. Zilton, dude, you're so creative, man. I love this. An extremely euphoric drug, which is extremely damaging with continued use. Taiho, do you want to tell you it's always nice and soothing to watch your stream? Nice, cool, man. I really appreciate it and enjoy what you're doing. Nice, thanks for saying that, Taiho. Appreciate you saying that a lot. It's very encouraging. An average dose of Steam Key only has a 25% chance of giving much greater euphoric effect than ad quote. But of course, if these other drugs are bought, then nothing can be eaten because bugger all, you're out of points and you're left with eating rotten shark meat. Zilton, I think these may be the most creative, funny, and appropriate chat messages ever. Lime Studios, what's up, man? I think this might have worked. Okay, so now I'm going to run through a bunch of world seeds. Let's go back to scenes. Let's set this up so we got 52 tries. We're going to go through 52 worlds. Create them all. Here we go. Bull. Bull seeds only. False. Seeds only. We're going to do 1,000 worlds with seeds only. Otherwise, we're just going to do 52 worlds. Here we go. If seeds only, else. This creates a world. Otherwise, seeds only just goes. Sets a seed. All right. All right, so it's generating 52 worlds here. It's just ripping through them all. It's trying to fail. And what I want to see is how many... Okay, there. We finally got this failed to break out of this loop thing. I wanted to catch this. And I want to make sure that... Okay, so what do we got? We got two dead ends that are possible. We've got level number 4. Should be the last one. We've already failed once. So it's going to go level equals 0, and then it should break out of this entire loop because level is no longer greater than level split. Yeah, okay, that worked. I'm glad that worked. Keep running. Can bots get addicted to ad quotes too? Probably. Only 350 more points? Dude, let me help you out a little. I know I'm helping you out a lot of streams, but... Okay, so what did it do? Did it fail here at the end, or what? Invalid area? I'm not exactly sure why this failed here, but what world seed is this? World seed ZZZZZZYR. This is one of those worlds that you were saying about earlier that you just, no matter what you do, you can't fix this one. That's okay. Let's see what we had for the results of all that. You should write a whole story on it, man, for sure. Hey, look at that. World ZZZZZZ succeeded on the first try. That's what I want to see. That's a nice world. Give those worlds to speedrunners. Okay, this is kind of breaking my flow here because I want to see this whole thing succeed to see what is the maximum world that has like the most amount of retries. What's up, Space My Name? Invalid area. Maybe I could figure it out. Get tile ref. If A... Oh. We got X1, Y0. What's A? A is null. It's trying to play some stairs here. Call set tile. Wait, where is it placing these stairs at? Set tile X1, Y20. Oh. Really? Place stairs. Oh. Okay, so it's trying to place some stairs at the very top of an area. All right, I'm just going to make sure this is a valid position before it calls set tile here. If this is valid, valid pause x, what do we got? Oh, pause.x plus xx. This is pause.y plus yy. Then we set this position. So that should fix this edge case here. We had a pretty random thing there where if was trying to place its stairs a little too high and then it tried to put some other tiles up there and it hadn't already been to that world or hadn't already created that other area, it got that to happen. You've been working mostly? How's progress? The progress is going amazing. Songbringer is getting so awesome. When I played it this last Saturday, dude, I'm starting to get addicted to my own game. Like, I can't wait to go play more hours because it's just getting addictive, man. It's like exploring the dungeons and finding all these new items and, like, everything is just really coming together. The game feels better than it ever has. And I'm starting to think of it as a professional game now. I mean, it's, like, really good. And I can't wait to see where it goes in the next few months until release. What's up, Teak? 216 already? I gotta get going soon, guys. But let's see if this all succeeds, then I can check this last bit of code in. Yeah, look, it totally succeeded. Several tries in, it generated this world. Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Yah. Z-Z-Z-Z-Y-A. Z-Yah! Z-Yah! And it succeeded after 12 retries to create this world. Look at that! Look how interesting that is. It put level 9 in the middle. 8 and 7 and 5 got on the right side, but that whole right side of the map is like cut off from the rest of the world by a pathway. There's two pathways in the middle green part that can get up there, but seriously, that's a crazy world. And it's got a secret hidden store. This is an interesting world. Okay, let's see how that turned out. Glad to hear it. Yeah. Yeah, what's Space My Name? Remind me of the game you're working on. What's it called? What's it about? All right, so I'm just looking through these worlds. Oh, I should see at the end, it's going to say so many retries. Where did it go? Where is this? Max retry count. Z-Z-Z-Z-Q. With ZZZZQ. Okay, so we're gonna set that world. I feel like there needs to be some platform to rate seeds and comment on the levels, but I assume Reddit would do the job. Huh. Yeah, I'm sure there needs to be a wiki too at some point. Like, there's gonna be a lot more lore and interesting facts about the world you're exploring and stuff too. And that might be a good place to put that information and the cool seeds. I don't know. Oh, on the space exploration game, right? Like a 2D No Man's Sky, sweet. Right on. That's a cool idea. This is great. This is really great. I can check this code in. This is like a. Let me turn that off. And the debug aspect of Maze Gen. And we can check this in. This is a fix for that area bug. And this is the has dead end, which makes more optimal mazes. Really interesting here. More optimal dead ends. That's really awesome. And then we've got some other functionality to the seeds tester. Let me make sure I did this right. Yep. X minus one, X plus one, Y minus one, Y plus one. Yeah, this is all good. And I checked has that in like three times thinking about it. All right, good. So this is prefer dead ends to be not right next to each other. All right, cool. Now, all right, so from doing that test right there with all those worlds, we found that world ZZZZZQ had the most amount of retries, which is 37. 37 freaking retries is actually a lot. So let's figure out why world ZZZZZQ has so many retries. And this is great because we can find the next most important thing to fix. And that's pretty much going to be it for today's stream. I've got a lot of freaking awesome random number changes, and all this is meant to make every world unique. That's my goal. And also it for the world generator to create each world almost effortlessly. Like, there really should be no flaws in how it creates worlds, and that would really optimize things. Look at that. It broke level 6 in this one. This is a great world to check because level 6 is just totally broken right there. I'm gonna need to figure this out and look at this world in more detail. Took 37 retries. So let me look at what might be causing the biggest amount of retries, and that's gonna be it for today's stream. We got, okay, ZZZQ, the first world seed, no possible doors for room. Unbalanced level entrances. God, I didn't really fix that, did I? All that code, no fixing going on. No possible parent rooms. Unconnected maze segment. No possible doors for room. I think the next thing I'm going to focus on tonight is to work on the no possible doors for room. I'm seeing this one a lot. And this has to do with the dungeon generator versus the overworld generator. So this is a totally different random generator. But the no possible parent rooms and also no possible doors, I think these are both related. And if I could fix that, I think I could fix a lot more of these issues. Look how many of these are no possible doors or parent rooms. Parent rooms, doors. See, there's a lot of these. Man, if I could fix this one, I can fix a lot of retries. So that'll be my next thing. Thanks, Space My Name. I thank you so much for sharing, Songbringer. I appreciate that. I'm only one man, so your help marketing is very much greatly appreciated. All right. So, yeah, we'll see you guys. You're relieved to see me using version control. Of course I've been using version control. Every single commit. How many commits do I have? How do you see how many commits you've used? I don't remember. But there's like zillions of commits already. Oh, I can look at my build number. Every time I commit, I think the build number increases. No, every time I build. Never mind. Whatever. All right, so we'll see you guys next time. Same wizard time, same wizard place. Tomorrow I'll be working on something totally different, and we'll see when we get there. So cheers, everybody. Have a good night. Thanks for watching.